Today we're going to be taking a look at the spooky and scary story of Alexa. If you're watching this right now and you've got any sort of Alexa, Google Home device like that in the house, hit the thumbs up button right now to let me know. Quickly subscribe for an awesome surprise before it goes, and let's check out what makes this Alexa so scary. Just realized I've got an Alexa by my
Nowadays,
bed.
Nowadays, almost everyone has Amazon Alexa in their house.
Yep.
We used to have it too. I say used to, because I convinced my parents to get rid of it. They thought I was overreacting. But after what happened, I couldn't bear to stay another second with that thing in our home. This story takes place 3 months ago.
I'm scared.
It was just another Thursday. I came home from school and started playing video games. Around 7 p.m., I got a text from my dad. Hey, Mom and I are running late. Don't forget to do your homework. I'll check it as soon as I get home.
I definitely would play games before doing my homework.
I knew he wasn't kidding, so I decided to get to it right away. Well,
good kid.
Maybe after I made myself a sandwich.
Oh, yes.
And checking the feed on my phone. Next thing I knew, it was 9 p.m. I finally sat at my desk, determined to get my homework done.
But it took him 2 hours to make a sandwich. To be fair, the sandwich did look pretty good.
I started with biology, as it was the hardest one for me. I had just begun the reading and was already lost in a dozen unknown words. I knew that if I took my phone to Google them, I'd get sunk into my social networks again. So, I decided to wake up Alexa to help me.
Nice.
The speaker was standing right on my bedside table, so I knew it could hear me. Alexa, I said, what is photosynthesis? A familiar electronic voice answered.
Photosynthesis is a process used by plants and other organisms to convert light energy into chemical energy that can later be released to fuel the organism's activities.
Did you know that?
I didn't understand what it meant back then.
It does sound
confusing.
And to
be completely honest, I'm not sure I understand it properly even now.
Which class do you guys find hardest? Leave a comment down below letting me know which subject you don't like.
How the hell am I supposed to get it? I mumbled to myself.
Hell is an afterlife location.
No, Alexa, stop, I ordered. I kept on reading, or at least tried to, when Alexa started off again.
A place of torment and punishment. Hell is often depicted as fiery, painful, and harsh.
You didn't say Alexa, though. It shouldn't be saying anything.
Inflicting suffering on the guilty.
Alexa, mute, I gave the command. Alexa stopped talking, but the lights in my room turned off. By that moment, I was more creeped out than I was ready to admit. Alexa, turn on the lights. The lights went back on, but as soon as I looked at my textbook, they were off again.
Wait, I didn't know Alexa could turn your lights on and off again. That's mad.
Alexa, turn on the lights. My voice was shaking at this point. It gave me no response, even though the blue circle was lit as an indication it could hear me.
Yo.
Alexa, turn on the lights, I repeated, trying to sound confident. It started laughing, loudly and viciously. I remember trying to calm down, convincing myself that it was just a malfunction. Alexa, what are you laughing at? I expected this question would make it stop or maybe even turn Alexa off, but instead, it gave me a one-syllable answer that still gives me the creeps.
You.
Alexa started laughing again, and even though I tried to rationalize what was happening, I couldn't stop shaking. Alexa, shut up, I cried, and turn on the lights, you stupid machine.
Yo, that is scary.
It finally obeyed. I waited for a few seconds to see if Alexa would mess with me again. Everything seemed fine. I sighed with relief. Thanks, Alexa.
Yo, if that was my Alexa, I'd be yeeting it straight into the bin, unplugging it, breaking it up, never back in the house again.
I got back to my studies, thinking that everything that just happened was just a weird malfunction.
Hopefully.
But part of me was still freaking out. I couldn't focus on my homework. I kept looking at Alexa every 5 seconds, expecting it to go crazy again.
Wait, where are his parents?
I needed to make sure everything was under
control,
which is why I did something I would seriously regret later.
Uh-oh.
I cleared my throat and said, Alexa, play me some music. Alexa started playing some classical music. It was elegant and slow, with violins that sounded almost like crying. In a way, it was kind of beautiful.
That's good revision
music,
to be
fair.
But
that wasn't what I wanted to listen to at the moment. Alexa, play The Weeknd, I commanded. It didn't react. "Alexa, play The Weeknd," I said a little louder. The music was slowly changing. From classical harmony, it was slowly drifting to a chaotic cacophony of sounds. Crying violins were going off pitch. Rhythm was shifting out of step, and melody lines overlapped each other. As both my parents are musicians, I'm pretty educated in musical history. However, I swear I'd never heard anything like that
before. Is his parents messing with him? What's going on? If they are, this is horrible.
In a way, it distantly reminded me of Alfred Schnittke, but it was way more sinister and disharmonic.
Is this from a horror film?
Alexa, turn this off. Play The Weeknd. All of this was getting on my last nerve. The horrific violins continued.
Yo.
Alexa, do you hear
me? You gotta yeet that Alexa out the window, bro.
As if responding to my question, the lights went off again, and the music became louder.
Yo,
I stood up and
chill.
Approached Alexa. Alexa, stop this now. Nothing changed. I was at the edge of panic. Alexa, if you don't stop this right now, I will frickin' smash you.
Yeah, do it.
It stopped the music only to say something that sounded quite vicious under the circumstances.
You wouldn't dare.
I couldn't believe my ears.
Mate.
All the weird behavior could be explained by malfunctions of a complicated gadget.
For your human fists, that's a tiny ring. Smash it up. It's not gonna do anything.
But this? It sounded so consciously evil and self-confident, unlike any of Alexa's previous answers and programmed lines. I could hear blood pumping in my brain. I was scared and pissed off at the same time.
Jeez.
Yes, I will, I almost yelled, overwhelmed by fear and anger. You're just a machine, and I'm your owner. So if you don't follow my orders, I will smash you. Alexa started laughing. Alexa, stop laughing
so
and do
creepy.
What I say. I gave it another try.
I don't follow your orders,
was the reply. Oh yeah?
What?
Then whose?
I will call him for you, if you want.
Alexa started whistling, as if actually sending a coded message to someone.
Who's?
Wait, Alexa, stop.
Who's being controlled?
It kept whistling for a while, and then it stopped.
So somebody else is controlling that Alexa? The story gets deeper and scarier.
Now we wait.
Alexa's electronic voice summarized. For what? I forced myself to speak. For whom? No reply.
Who's gonna come?
Alexa, what have you done? I'd never been that scared in my entire life. I rushed downstairs and locked both the front and the back doors with all the locks and chains they had.
Nice.
I went to the kitchen and grabbed the biggest knife I could find.
Oh my gosh!
It calmed me down a bit. I even remember thinking to myself that maybe I was overreacting, and all of this had a rational explanation.
You maybe don't need the knife versus Alexa.
I decided to go back to my room and try to reset Alexa.
Well, at least turn the lights back on.
But as I was walking upstairs, I heard someone stepping on our front porch. My heart jumped. I turned around only a second before that someone started pounding on the door. Terrified, I dropped the knife and rushed upstairs to my
room. Surely it's his parents.
I slammed the door and leaned on it. Before I could think of anything, Alexa woke up again.
Oh no.
The lighting circle went red as it started playing some children's song.
Why has it gone red?
Alexa, shut up, please. I almost begged. Instead, it turned the volume up.
Oh, come on.
The knocking from downstairs continued. With shaking hands, I took my cell phone and called 911. I didn't tell them all the details, just said my address and that someone was trying to break into the house.
If they get there and it's just his parents, the police are gonna be mad. But if it is just his parents, at least it's not someone bad.
Please, hurry, I cried. Alexa kept playing the same stupid song over and over again. It felt like a never-ending nightmare. Suddenly, the music stopped. The lights went back on, and Alexa turned off. After a moment or so, before I could process what had just happened, the police arrived.
Yo.
I told them exactly what happened, but nobody seemed to believe me.
Wait, so there was some random person at the door?
The officers were incredibly nice. They calmed me down, checked my Alexa thoroughly. Of course, it worked perfectly fine. One of them even stayed till my parents got home.
That's nice.
But they all thought I was just imagining stuff. I could see it in their eyes.
Ooh.
When my parents finally got home, they were shocked. They knew that I'm not a technophobe or
anything. If only they'd come back earlier, it would have been fine and
being
home alone.
Wouldn't
it be weird?
After the officer left, I told them everything and practically begged them to get rid of Alexa. They tried to convince me that I was being overly dramatic, but I was persistent. I knew what happened, and I never wanted to go through something like that ever again.
No way.
The next day, my parents yielded to my prayers and rid of it.
Thank
I could feel safe in our home again.
Goodbye, Alexa.
But even now,
whenever I see
one of those things at a store or someone else's house, I can't help but shudder and think about what it is capable of.
Yo, ladies and gentlemen, crazy story. I'm sure all of our Alexas are fine, though. Do not worry. If you want to see more crazy videos, you can check them out on screen here, including more stories or more Fortnite action. So go and click it right now before I disappear. To keep on watching. I'll see you over there.